Hello students, today we are going to discuss indigo plantations. Why the demand for Indian indigo? India has tropical climate which is suitable for indigo. By the 13th century in Italy, France, Britain, Indian indigo was used by cloth dyers. The prices were very high, so only small amount reached to these countries. Most of the people depend on what? Grown in temperate zone. Indigo gives rich blue while what gives pale and dull blue. So Indian indigo was in great demand. What producers of Europe were worried by the competition from indigo. They demanded to ban on import of indigo. But cloth dyers preferred indigo. So they demanded to relax the ban on import of indigo. Europeans started indigo plantations in different parts of the world. Europeans started the cultivation of indigo in different parts of the world, for example, West Indies, America, Venezuela, etc. By the end of 18th century, the demand grew more. Britain began to industrialize and its cotton production expanded manifold. Supply from America and West Indies collapsed by 1783. It fell up to half. Cloth dyers looked for new sources of indigo. So demand of Indian indigo increased. In 1788, only 30% of the indigo imported into Britain from India. But by 1810, the proportion reached up to 95%. How was indigo cultivated? As indigo trade grew, commercial agents started investment in indigo production. Attracted by the profits, many Scotsmen and Englishmen came to India and became planters. There were two systems of indigo cultivation: niche cultivation and Ryoti cultivation. Let's discuss them in detail. Niche cultivation. Planter produced indigo on the lands that he directly controlled. Either bought the land or rented it from other jamidars. Indigo was planted by hiring labor. This system has some problems. First, difficult to expand area under indigo. The areas were densely populated, so for housing and meeting the food needs, maximum part was under food crops. Labor problems were there because the indigo cultivation coincided with the cultivation of rice. Same time labor is required on rice fields. British also faced infrastructure related problems because for 1 bigha they need 1 plough and 2 bullock, and if the area is larger then they need more, and this demand cannot be fulfilled. Less than 25% area of indigo cultivation was under niche cultivation. Second system of indigo cultivation was known as Ryoti cultivation. Ryots were forced to sign a contract. At times, village headmen were pressurized to sign an agreement on behalf of Ryots. Ryot who signed the contract got cash advances from planters at low rate of interest to grow indigo. The loan committed the Ryot to grow indigo on at least 25% of the area under his holding. Planter provides seeds and drill. Cultivator prepared the soil, sowed the seeds and looked after the crop. This is all about indigo plantation. Thank you.